Bitcoin trickling down, fueling speculation we could be headed for another crypto crash. Let's investigate, as it is time now for the world of cryptocurrency news in 15 minutes or less. And I'm not a financial advisor. I'm veteran newsman Gavin Dawson. Welcome into the Crypto Daily News, available on YouTube, plus podcast and streaming at Blockchain Radio. Bitcoin is at 31.8, trickling down all week. BTC dominance at 44.1, pretty flat. Crypto total global market caps at 1.7% down. That's at 1.35 trillion. And the Crypto Fear and Greed Index, extreme fear continues. We're at 20. Okay, winners and losers. Hey, the good news right now, nothing big has happened yet. We're chilling, sliding back a little, but nothing major. No catastrophic damage. And even some assets in the green. Let's take a look at these winners. Axie Infinity continues to dominate and lead the way. A big NFT revival trend ongoing. Nearly doubled for the week. It's up another 16% and approaching $27. Chili's up 7%. They're at 26 cents. KuCoin and Ecomi, your biggest losers, down 9.5-10% there. Okay, crypto news you could use, and the top story is the dwindling price of Bitcoin and major alts. We're preparing to test support at 30K for BTC. Volumes down considerably from last week amid concerns of a bear market and the possibility of a sell-off following the Grayscale unlock. A lot of uncertainty, and the bulls are at risk of losing more support levels. And now for the first time, dips to these key support levels are not being met by heavy buy pressure. Year-to-date gains are now at just 12%. The last time we really had bullish momentum was June 29th, 2.5 weeks ago, when BTC hit 36.6, and the market appears to be in a state of near paralysis. It is widely known, after a sustained period of excruciating sideways action, the information available has become confusing, difficult to interpret. There's so much bullish and bearish movement and headlines, and the indicators don't agree with one another. When that happens, typically investors and traders check out, and that's where we are today. But hey, if this was easy, everybody'd do it. Okay, let's take a look at some of this FUD. Fed Chair Powell hints on digital dollar timing. This is Fox Business, as the Fed Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell said that the central bank was advancing research and public outreach regarding its own digital dollar. A white paper could be released this fall. We expect to publish a report. Could be early September, says Jerome, plus or minus in that time frame. We're working hard on it right now. The report's going to address digital payments broadly, including items like stablecoins and crypto assets, which Powell said are at a critical point in terms of the appropriate regulation. We want to begin really a major public consultation across many different groups, including Congress, particularly. You wouldn't need stablecoins, he said, and you wouldn't need cryptocurrencies if you had a digital U.S. currency. I think that's one of the stronger arguments in its favor, said Powell. I can see not needing stablecoins, but not needing any cryptocurrencies. Until you find out the digital dollar would be decentralized, which it wouldn't, and the U.S. government has no backdoor into the code, which they would, there is no way in H-E double hockey sticks the cryptocurrency world is going to agree with you on that one, Mr. Powell. Cardano News. ADA's Charles Hoskinson introduces a novel algorithmic stablecoin. U.today with the headline and the details. He tweeted last night, been busy. Had some pictures of math notes and equations on paper. Bottom line is, the new protocol, dubbed DIED, acts like an autonomous bank, means that pegging to basic fiat currency by buying and selling underlying assets is insured. At the same time, the share of crypto is stored in reserve to hedge against market volatility. The bank also trades reserve currency in order to capitalize itself. Meanwhile, Alonzo White Hard Fork has gone live. In a series of tweets, IOHK reports it's already making blocks. The full release of Alonzo, still looking at a loose date of August. It'll bring on board a number of upgrades, including the ability to host decentralized apps. The dApps coming to Cardano. Many believe the utility and popularity of ADA will explode even further next month. Okay, elsewhere, Italy becomes the seventh nation to warn its citizens about Binance. Binance, the world's largest exchange, has been pretty cavalier about not playing the regulator games, and now the consequences perhaps are being realized for them. This is Gemini founders, the Winklevoss twins, the Winklevi, have made headlines saying their plan to become the largest exchange is to simply do what the regulators ask. Who do you think is going to win out on this one? You really can't fight the man and win for long, can you? Okay, we'll see what CZ decides to do. How about this story from Crypto Potato, though? FTX CEO says buying Goldman Sachs is not out of the question. Make and move. Sam Bankman-Fried, salute to you. The CEO of the crypto exchange FTX believes the digital asset company can acquire some of the most prominent traditional financial firms. The 29-year-old executive went further, stating that his firm could possibly buy the Chicago Mercantile Exchange and even Goldman Sachs if it manages to overtake its competitors. If we are the largest, buying Goldman and CME is not out of the question at all, said Sam Bankman-Fried. Every time we turn around, FTX is making a big sponsorship deal, and to hear Sam tell it, maybe they're just getting started. Bankman-Fried also revealed FTX had plans to go public on a traditional stock exchange, but such ideas are currently postponed. Quote, we're in a happy position that we do not have to do this because we do not need capital. On the other hand, there are potentially great benefits to listing, such as brand recognition. We do not want to actively list, but we want to be able to continue if we want to. Next headline, CoinDesk with a story about Ethereum co-founder Vitalik Buterin. A documentary film team is working on the first feature-length doc about Ethereum, and they're looking for ETH donations to fund it. The name Ethereum, the Infinite Garden, will feature interviews with various people involved in the development of the world computer, including the network's co-creator Vitalik Buterin and Aya Miyaguchi, the executive director of the Ethereum Foundation. Sports crypto news. New York Giants running back Saquon Barkley, the latest athlete to move into taking his income in Bitcoin. He was on Anthony Pompliano's business show, says, quote, you see how high inflation is and you learn you can't save yourself through wealth. That's why I'm going to be taking my marketing money in Bitcoin. His NFL salary, fiat U.S. dollars, his endorsement cash, all coming in BTC. Neighborhood Watch, where we look at what top tubers and tweeters are saying about the crypto space and pass it along to you. Pretty cool celebrity entering the crypto space, and he's creating significant conversation from last night into today. The rapper Busta Rhymes is tweeting, anyone here into crypto? And how are you feeling about it? He's taking feedback on that and other questions if you want to join that conversation on Twitter. We go to another Twitter thread here for the second day in a row. And this time, it's from one of the co-creators of Doge, a gentleman named Jackson Palmer at Jackson. He set crypto Twitter ablaze while tweeting, I'm often asked if I will return to cryptocurrency or begin regularly sharing my thoughts on the topic again. My answer is a wholehearted no. But to avoid repeating myself, I figure it might be worthwhile briefly explaining why. After years of studying, I believe crypto is an inherently right-wing, hyper-capitalistic technology built primarily to amplify the wealth of its proponents through a combination of tax avoidance, diminished regulatory oversight, and artificially enforced scarcity. Despite claims of decentralization, the crypto industry is controlled by a powerful cartel of wealthy figures who, with time, have evolved into incorporating many of the same institutions tied to the existing centralized financial system they supposedly set out to replace. The crypto industry leverages a network of shady business connections, bought influencers, and pay-for-play media outlets to perpetuate a cult-like get-rich-quick funnel designed to extract new money from the financially desperate and naive. Financial exploitation undoubtedly existed before crypto, but crypto is almost purpose-built to make the funnel of profiteering more efficient for those at the top and less safeguarded for the vulnerable. Okay, so a lot said in there from Mr. Palmer. You know, my take, I do not want to get into politically polarizing discussions right here on the CDN. I don't know about everything he says, but I do think in general, the rich controlling investments is probably accurate. accurate. And I think there are people on both sides of the aisle that participate and profit from it. So to call it inherently right wing, I think is a little bit naive itself. So I don't think we need to get partisan at all. But the real takeaway for me is that it really puts a spotlight on the fact that if you were into investing, follow the patterns of the rich and not the retail. That applies for literally everything in your financial life. So thanks for the food for thought on that, Mr. Jackson Palmer. Cheers to you for checking us out, gents and ladies. Salute. Remember, none of the preceding messages, financial advice, it's just news and some opinion thrown in, hopefully a laugh or two along the way from time to time. Whether you are listening on YouTube or podcast or streaming at Blockchain Radio, thanks for making us part of your day. And hey, we'd love to chat with you. So subscribe, like it, comment, whatever you want to do. Until tomorrow, for the GD Crypto News Team, covering the world of crypto one Satoshi at a time, I'm Gavin Dawson. At ease.